In this video, I'm going to show you how to install Visual Studio Code and the Node.js. Let's get started. Now we are going to a Microsoft Visual Studio Code website. Okay, this is the website. We are going in there. Use your version of operating system. I use Windows. Let's put it here. As it finished, you open it at the end. Okay, now it's opening. Okay, you press next, accept the agreement, the default folder, next, I mark all those things. This is a very light version of Visual Studio. I love it for developing in a JavaScript, in Angular. It's good for this. Okay, now that we finished, let's launch Visual Studio Code. Okay, this is the Visual Studio Code. Let's make a preferences to a write on a write code on a Angular. Okay, those are the right preference to get a smooth work on Angular. You have to copy all of this. Please freeze your screen and copy this. Okay, all of these you copy. I will show you to where you copy those. Copy it and you go to file. You go to file, preferences, settings. And you place it here. Okay, those preferences. This is a light screen. If you want a dark screen, you can erase this. Okay, and this is the font size. This is. This is very important, the autosave. Okay, now after we did this, let's save it and close the screen. Okay, this is the welcome screen. Let's install let's close this Visual Studio Code and let's it install the Node.js. we seek for Node.js and we're going to download. Okay, very important, if the latest version doesn't work, you go to the recommended. Okay, let's try the latest first. Latest Windows installer, and we download it again. This is installing the Node.js and also the required npm for Angular. Let's open it. Okay, we are waiting a bit long, but please be patient with the installer. You better do this if you on the Windows 10 or 8 or 7, you can do the 64-bit installer. It will take you a while to install, so please be patient. And now let's continue. We do next. Accept. Okay, let's finish it. Now we open CMD to see if the installation was okay. We do CMD. Okay, we open the command prompt. As you see, I wish it was bigger for you to see. Now we do node node minus v, and it's show the version if the installation was okay. Now you can see it shows a version 10.4.1, so the installation was okay. Now let's check the npm this requires for for Angular. npm minus v. Okay, npm minus v, and it shows 6.1.0. okay, so it's n p and m. Okay, now you can install Angular extension. I will show you. you search in on a Google Angular, this is the website, and you go to there and you go to get started, and you copy this code to install the Angular CLI globally. Okay, you must install the CLI on your a C disk. So let's do CD slash. Okay, we are on the first a library directory of C, and we do this npm install. This is mean installing minus g. This means installing globally for all the folders on the computer to see the installation. Minus it's for the g and the Angular CLI. Okay, the npm is the global installer manager for Google. Okay, so now we press here, and it will take time, but in the end it will install the Angular CLI. Okay, it will take time, we're pausing. In the meantime, I will show you this. This what you should write on the CMD, on the command line, npm install minus g angular slash CLI. Okay. Installation was complete. Let's check the version. We do npm minus v. npm minus v 6.1, and we do let's see how do we check version. Let's see, now let's check if the Angular CLI was installed properly. We do the simple check and ng space minus v. This is the sign for version, and we wait, and it should do us this thing, Angular CLI, and everything is okay. So it's okay. Now let's say create example project of Angular. Okay, we go to the folder that we want to create the project. Let's say do CD downloads. Okay, I want to put the project folder here. So I do ng new for a new file, and my app. This is the example project for a CLI to see that everything is working. Okay, my app. Okay, now it will create the new app. It will take a while. Okay, now you can see the project is done. So we are going to activate it. Let's enter the folder that the project was created in. Okay, this is the folder, and we open the project by commanding serve. ng serve serve is the file that we need to open, and we command on it open. Okay, so now it's opened, and we have to open it on a let's do it on here. We do HTTP localhost. Let's see what's the problem. Okay, let's see what happened. HTTP localhost. And here we go. If you do this, it will give you your first app. After it, we will learn how to change the app. Okay, let's open Visual Studio Code and see what's happening inside. Show you something. If you want to stop this, you do a control and C, and yes, this stop the process. This stop the process. Now, if you want to open a new solution in a Visual Studio Code, you do this one. Let's say you want to do a new project on a Node.js. You go to file and you go to open folder. That's first. And you choose the folder that you want to put it, the project in it. Let's say okay, now let's put all our project on test. Select folder. This project will be called a test, and I will create a new file called server.js. Okay, if you do the JS extension, you do the JS sign. Okay, now you have a JS file. Okay, let's do a simple command to test it. Console.log. Try to execute it. You do a control and the sign a left to number one, and this will open the terminal from here. It's easier than the CMD. Okay, you have, and you do let's see. Okay, now you do we will check the test file. We do node and spacebar and the file name server and enter, and here it go. It executed the file. Okay, so this is working file, and we exit it all. Okay, now let's open the Angular file. Okay, we go to open folder like before, and we go to the file. Let's trace it. It was on my here. It was my app. So we open it. Select. Let's see what happens. Okay, now we see all the project folders and all of the things here. You see the source codes, the components. Okay, and here you can see the logo, the HTML file. Okay, the components. Okay, this is all for now. Thank you for joining me. We saw here how to install the AngularJS. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to contact me by replying this video, and I will try my best to answer you. Hope you enjoyed it. Bye bye.